Hello everyone, today we'll discuss part 23 of the important notes for biochemistry so that you can easily able to answer the one-liners and the MCQs in your exam. Hartnup disease is actually an autosomal recessive disease and also a rare disorder. In the Hartnup disease, there is defect in the neutral amino acid transporter, and because of this, there is failure of the absorption of the tryptophan from the intestine. And also, there is failure of the reabsorption of the tryptophan from the kidneys. There occurs massive aminoaciduria, mainly of the tryptophan, without a corresponding increase in the plasma amino acid level. And this is the characteristic feature of the Hartnup's disease. Now, in the Hartnup's disease, there is mutation on the gene SLC6A19. In the carcinoid syndrome, tryptophan is used to form excess serotonin or the 5-hydroxytryptamine. So, tryptophan to niacin conversion is not occurring. So, pellagra occurs in the carcinoid syndrome, because over here, most of the tryptophan are used to form excess serotonin, and so there is no conversion of tryptophan to niacin, which will actually cause pellagra. Catabolic end product of the histidine is the glutamate formed via formaminoglutamic acid or the FIGLU. Histidine has maximum buffering capacity because histidine is the only amino acid which can ionize within the physiological pH range. In terms of polarity, first of all arginine, then lysine, and then histidine comes. All basic amino acid, that is the histidine, arginine, lysine, and acidic amino acid, aspartic acid and the glutamic acid, are polar in nature. Arginine is glucogenic. Over here, the catabolic end product is the alpha ketoglutarate. Aspartic synthesis require ATP, and glutamine over here is the amino group donor. All acidic amino acids and their amides are glucogenic. Aspartic is the site for the N-glycosidic bonds. Serine and threonine are the hydroxy containing amino acid, and they're also the site for the O-glycosidic bonds. Cysteine and methionine are sulfur containing amino acid. Cysteine is oxidized to cysteine. Cysteine is oxidized to cysteine. A disulfide bond formation basically occurs over here. Methionine forms the S-adenosyl methionine, a methyl donor. SAM is actually a methyl donor. Methionine adenosyl transferase, the MAT, this methionine adenosyl transferase converts the methionine to SAM. So over here, this methionine adenosyl transferase basically converts the methionine to the S-adenosyl methionine. And this S-adenosyl methionine is actually a methyl donor. Okay. Methionine adenosyl transferase 1 and 3 is in the liver. Methionine adenosyl transferase 2 is in the extrahepatic tissues. S-adenosyl methionine and coenzyme A are highly energy compounds, or we can say highly energetic and energy containing compounds, but they do not have phosphate. Now, which reaction actually uses the S-adenosyl methionine as a methyl donor? So over here, this SAM is basically used in the norepinephrine to epinephrine conversion. Methyl group in the 7-methylguanosine cap in the mRNA is actually donated by the SAM. SAM is also used for the conversion of the cephalin to lecithin. Guanidinoacetate to creatine formation, SAM is used. And also, acetyl serotonin to melatonin is converted, okay, by the help of the methyl donated by the SAM. Cysteine is not an essential amino acid as long as methionine is available in diet. Tyrosine is not an essential amino acid as long as phenylalanine is available in the diet. Cysteine is made up of two molecules of cysteine. Cysteine has sulfhydryl group, but cysteine has disulfide bond. Homocysteine is increased in the blood in the vitamin B6, that is pyridoxine, vitamin B9, that is the folic acid, or vitamin B12, that is the cyanocobalamin deficiency. And as because of this, what will happen? the homocysteine is increased in the urine. Now in the type 1 homocystinuria, cysteine becomes essential. In the type 2 homocystinuria, cysteine can be synthesized in the body. For the formation of the cysteine, two amino acids are required, that is methionine and serine, and one vitamin is required, that is the vitamin B6. Cyanide nitroglycerin test is positive for homocystinuria, cystinuria and the cystinosis. In the cystinuria, there is a defect in the dibasic amino acid transporter. In cystinosis, there is defect in the cystine transporter, that is cystinosin, in lysosome. It is a generalized lysosomal storage disease. So cystinosis is actually a generalized lysosomal storage disease because of the defect in the cystine transporter named cystinosin in the lysosome. Cystinuria is the most common genetic error in the amino acid transport, and over here four amino acids, that is the cystine, ornithine, arginine and the lysine, appears in the urine. All amino acids have primary amino group except for the proline. This proline is actually having secondary amino group. Proline, that is having the imino group as the specialized group in it, can never be accommodated in the alpha helix. Catabolic end product of the proline is the glutathione. Rice lacks lysine, while the pulses basically lacks methionine, and so we should eat all the food item so that whatever amino acid is actually left in one food item can be we can gain that particular amino acid from the another food item. So today up till here, we'll discuss about the further important notes in our next video. Thank you so much.